Oh, he's now going for real speed. Matty Kay throttling it in.
The biggest competitor is from a billion-dollar bank.
Wow, this is fast.
Here on track two, we've got Krystle hungry for speed.
I'm currently developing an automated hydroponic garden.
Wow, this is a great model.
Chris is teaching himself.
Whoa, let's walk before you're in, dude.
The first man to go under 10 seconds is going to come right down to the wire here at DeepRacer Sydney. That right-hand turn, devil's corner.
Oh! It flies. I'm thinking it's going to go off the end. It's turned on a wheel's length as it comes around the final corner. Vegas is literally that far away.
Welcome to the world's first autonomous racing league. Developers of every skill level from all corners of the globe compete for the ultimate prize in machine learning. Welcome to DeepRacer TV. Sydney, Australia is truly an international city. With its iconic beaches and modern architecture, it's one of the top 10 visited cities in the world. Sydney also boasts the most tech startups in Australia and some of the most talented developers in the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are about to send off our first racer in the Sydney leg of the DeepRacer International Autonomous Racing League. Don't just watch, ladies and gentlemen, get involved. This might be your first ever interaction with machine learning.
I already did two models. Okay. They failed, I killed them. So I'm tweaking the reward function.
Okay. With racing open on three tracks over 2 days, this is the biggest event yet for AWS DeepRacer. Each developer will have 4 minutes to place their best time. They need to complete one full circuit around the track with less than three faults in order for their time to qualify.
It's Matty Kay, he's here on track three. Looking good, Matty Kay. Oh, he's now going for real speed. Matty Kay throttling it here. All four wheels on green, all four wheels on green. There we go, our second competitor at DeepRacer Sydney. Matty, how'd you find that?
Difficult.
We've had it confirmed. Matty Kay has logged a successful lap, 23.72 seconds. Can you handle just having people hunting you down for the next couple of days? Do you look ready, my friend?
I'm Matt, and I'm an IT manager. I'm here with four guys from GJI. I live back onto the Brisbane River. I take out a jet ski whenever I can. I've always been interested in racing. I guess this is taking it to the next level, autonomously.
Alan Lockley from GJI. Oh, that right-hand turn, devil's corner.
My name's Alan. I also work for GJI Group, and I'm a senior systems engineer looking after cloud technologies. I live in Brisbane, always passionate to learn new tech.
What would you say, 40?
Yeah, go for it.
I have a 9-year-old son. He's already talking about learning Python. And I'm like, oh, whoa, let's walk before you run, dude.
Oh, yeah, that looks good.
We're a really small, close-knit family. And I think the biggest competitor is from a billion-dollar bank.
Wow, this is a great model. Wow, this is fast. Solid times on this.
Heard a bit about the NAB team doing a fair bit of work offline pre-DeepRacer.
My name is Alan Chin. I work as a data scientist for the National Australia Bank. Months ago, NAB actually launched an internal DeepRacer competition. Fortunately, I won the internal competition. So that's the model I use today, actually.
Alan from NAB in the top position. It's a lot of NAB, it's a lot of GJI.
The National Australia Bank, they've had a chance to play with these models for a while. If you're handicapping this race, NAB is the team to watch.
Ladies and gentlemen, here on track two, Chris Nab 01.
My name is Chris Rhodes. I currently work for National Australia Bank as an intern software engineer. There is about 70 National Australia Bank employees at the summit, and there is about six participating in the race. I get very competitive. I think my family would describe me as intelligent and empathetic. I volunteer for Headspace, an Australian organisation that is focused on counselling and psychology services for youth.
You're slowing down, man.
My first model was actually a dud. It didn't stay on the track properly, and that model was actually a bit more experimental.
A mistake a lot of people run into is believing that the centre line is the safe line, but by over-incentivizing the center, you're forcing the deep racer to almost slow down, so the wheels will just kind of this little jitter shaking back and forth. You're not going to get anywhere fast that way. Tell me about the model you used.
It was trained quite a lot.
Okay. How long did you train it?
For about 30 hours.
Chris has just finished a model that took 36 hours to train. The problem there is a problem called overfitting. By training the same model on the same virtual track for so many hours, the model gets really good at exactly that track and exactly that conditions. But any variance on that, and the model gets confused. Like, I'm sorry, I'm a dog. I'm taught to sit, but only if I'm in the kitchen. I'm in the living room now. I don't know how to sit in the living room. I only know how to sit in the kitchen.
These are impressive opening times. We could see some people knocking on the door of the magic 10-second mark.
Right now, as we're looking at how this day is progressing, we've got two major teams, NAB and GJI, both of which are committed to win this competition. But one of the great things about DeepRacer is its engineers to truly democratize this technology of machine learning. DeepRacer is not just a remote control car. It's a mobile computer that runs on an open source Intel platform that developers are already comfortable using. You don't have to come in with years of experience and a whole team behind you. Anybody can do it.
Chris from Vision is currently sitting in fifth place. Just arrived here today, done the workshop, and had a couple of goes.
Go, go, go! Good luck.
We have a new number one, 10.14 seconds. Chris, yeah, come on, people. Get in there around and get around big Chris from Vision. Ladies and gentlemen, that's the new number one, 10.14 seconds. Good luck, Chris.
Thank you.
My main man, yeah.
Chris, how you doing?
Good, thanks.
Do you use machine learning at all outside of DeepRacer?
I'm using machine learning for my gardens.
Nice. This is the first time I've seen this for gardening.
My name is Chris Garces. I work for a telecommunications company. I'm an RF engineer. I'm also currently doing part-time studies. So I've done machine learning. Now I have three children, so I'm currently juggling studies, family, and work.
Here, I grow some tomatoes.
I'm currently developing an automated hydroponic garden. I have a dual lens camera that monitors the health of the plant, so it will adjust the amount of nutrients based on what it sees. Yeah, what would mean to me if I win this competition is just an affirmation of my abilities and a trip to Las Vegas, so it's quite exciting. I've never been to that place before.
Okay, I like the sound of that. All right, good luck with that.
Thank you.
Chris is teaching himself, and that real-world experience may just leapfrog him over these juggernauts that have come in prepared as a team. This individual just might be the one to spoil everyone else's day.
Ladies and gentlemen, here on track two, we've seen him already on our leaderboard.
I looked at how it performed earlier today, and I noticed it was trying to turn a lot, trying to do minor corrections. I just try and learn and keep going.
Now in the guise of ChrisNab02, we might have some action on the leaderboard to reveal in just a couple of seconds. 9.23 seconds, the first man to go under 10 seconds at DeepRacer Sydney. You'd have to be happy with that, Chris.
Yeah, I'm happy I broke the 10-second mark, but also I'm happy I beat the other NAB employee.
Yeah, there's a fair bit of NAB love going on, mate. Congratulations, we will see you tomorrow looking sharper and better. Great stuff.
Thank you.
Would have won Dubai, would have won Amsterdam, would have won Paris. And we logged it here in Sydney on day one.
We're back at the Innovation Convention Center for day two of AWS DeepRacer Sydney.
Yep, ready.
Here on track two, we've got Krystle. Good luck, Krystle. Hungry for speed. Whoa, there you go. 12.7 seconds. Let's give Krystle a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Currently sitting in seventh place.
I'm Krystle Whittaker. I work for Champion Data. We're a sport data broadcast company. I enjoy all sport games. I love video gaming, which is always a bit of a shock to people when I say that. I play a lot of the story character games, so like Red Dead Redemption and Uncharted's one of my favourite ever. And I did notice there's less girls here, but I think it will slowly change, more females will get involved.
I'm hearing some word that there might be a bit of activity about to take place on the leaderboard, ladies and gentlemen.
We placed, I think, 4th, 5th and 7th yesterday. And we want to try and get on the podium.
Has the sleepless nights and the Red Bulls and pizza paid off? We'll find out on track 3 in just a couple of seconds.
During our little hackathon on Tuesday night, we threw some models into different iterations in for training on multiple accounts.
We also started looking online at the previous summit winners to see if we could get any tips from them. I actually reached out to Mathieu from the French summit and he emailed me back straight away. Thank you very much.
Matt's getting ready to go, and then all of a sudden, he hits it. It flies, I'm thinking it's gonna go off the end. It's turned. It's then gone through the kink in the track, finished the lap with a margin on literally a wheel's length as it comes around the final corner. There's some questions over to whether it stayed on the track or not.
We have some movement near the very, very top here on track 3. After consulting with the judges, we have a time of 8.29 seconds.
We had 3 different judges go, that's on, that's good. The absolute blinder of a lap, 8 seconds. There's some rumors that it's one of the fastest in the world.
Maddie from GJI, ladies and gentlemen, throwing down the gauntlet to the two Chris's who are in line.
We then realize, first place, Las Vegas is in our reach.
Ladies and gentlemen, there is officially 1 hour to go. Can anyone go under 8.29 seconds?
Seems like the top guys in the leaderboard are iterating as much as they can, so I don't think any spot is safe.
My man Chris from Vision Stream just recorded an 8.97 and rocking into second place. Chris!
I'm now sitting at the second position. Yeah, looking at the time difference from first to second, it's only a fraction of a second. I feel that I still have a chance to be on top.
Can you take another 0.7 off? Can you get under 8.29?
Yeah, I'll try.
Go to the back of the line, mate.
I am committed to win this race.
We stop the clocks at 3:45.
Last 15 minutes of the day, it's intense. There's a lot of energy in the room. Hundreds of people watching.
Chris from NAB, about to have his final shot at the title.
There's a guy from National Australia Bank. I've scoped him out.
And I can see he's got a run coming up. We're not sure if he's got something up his sleeve, if he's got a new improved model. He needs one lap, that's all he needs.
You can see some nervous looks now.
I'm pretty stressed. This last model is a bit experimental. I've been training it basically the entirety of last night and today. At a higher throttle, that would be more unstable, but potentially achieve a quicker track time.
I'm watching his lap. I'm not sure which way to look. It looks like whatever he's done with his model, it hasn't worked.
Come back here!
The model wasn't ready. It would discontinuously go off the track and it would hit that 3 limit and have to reset to the start.
From his face, it seems he's a little bit disappointed with his result.
Mate, you gave it your absolute best. You've quite possibly got a podium finish. You must be proud of that.
Yeah, it's good.
It was a complete and utter failure.
Unfinished business, I like it about you. Give me another round of applause. This guy's been absolutely epic over the last couple of days. Well done, mate.
It's my chance now. This is the last race of the day.
The guy in second place was just able to get on the track. Extremely nerve-wracking. It was the final hurdle.
Vegas is literally that far away.
Chris from Vision Stream's got a couple of minutes left opposed to winning time.
The car seems to start really slow, so I made an adjustment of the speed, goes up to 60%, and it performs one complete lap.
He's put one very zinging lap down already, coming down to our final 30 seconds, so let's do this.
So I increased the speed to 85%, and seems like the car is a little bit wobbly.
It's going to come right down to the wire here at DeepRacer Sydney.
And it went straight to the fence. That was my last chance.
in third place, Chris from NAB.
I definitely feel like I did NAB justice. My team members were very happy for me and they were very proud.
In second place, this guy was a real crowd favourite. He went so close. Bring Chris from Vision Stream up here. Chris, my man.
It's a little bit disappointing because I told my kids that we could be in Las Vegas.
Hold that trophy up there, mate. Yeah.
Second is the first loser.
With the second fastest time in the history of the Deep Racer League worldwide, 8.29 seconds. Matt from GJI, give him a cheer, ladies and gentlemen. Your winner.
We were all very surprised. We certainly weren't planning on getting to number one. We were just hoping to get into the top 10 to walk home with a Deep Racer.
Congratulations, you're off to reInvent. You must be pumped about that too.
Very.
Give him a round of applause. Your winner for the Deep Racer League in Sydney.
The time we got is the second fastest in the world, so it's already not good enough. There'll be a few late nights leading up to reInvent because we're going to have to knock a few seconds off. We want to represent Australia and take home the gold.
That closes us out for AWS DeepRacer Sydney. Remember, there are two ways to punch your ticket for the AWS DeepRacer Champions Cup at reInvent 2019. Win first place at an AWS Summit or place atop the leaderboard on the AWS DeepRacer virtual circuit. Now open for racing at deepracerleague.com.